We are reducing the wild mosquito population because they are the number one threat to our native species here in Hawaii. They transmit avian malaria, which is killing our native birds. Sophie, there were how many pods in this? 256? And you removed one? Okay. So we are the Maui Forest Bird Recovery Project. We are a part of a greater partnership known as Birds Not Mosquitoes. We are loading up a helicopter with the equipment that we use to deploy the incompatible male mosquitoes. So this is what a pod looks like. And so inside of here is about 1,000 male mosquitoes. We have about 250 pods, so that's 250,000 mosquitoes that are gonna go out today. They don't bite, they don't transmit disease. Their purpose is to mate with wild females and reduce the population of mosquitoes in the areas that we put them. Someone sitting in the back of the helicopter will wait until the person in the front calls 3, 2, 1, drop, and then they'll uncap the pod, drop the males down below, and say sayonara. Mosquito spread disease is the number one threat to our native honey creepers. We have tried many of the other conservation management techniques to try to prevent the kiwiku, the okohe-kohe from going extinct. And those haven't been successful because birds are continuing to die in the wild because of avian malaria. If mahi's totally clouded out, it might be worth trying for keepa half of it and then coming back and visiting it. We want to get a full application as best we can at the mahi site. Mosquito control and incompatible insect technique has been done all across the world for decades to combat diseases. We're building on that foundation here in Hawaii, and that has given us confidence that this is going to be effective in combating a wildlife disease. There has been a significant amount of research leading up to this project. And that research has been done by people who are very invested in conserving species here in Hawaii, who have backgrounds and extensive knowledge in how well these techniques work. And so we wouldn't be doing it here if those people didn't have evidence of it being safe and effective.
So we're in Waikumoi Preserve right now in an area where there is a lot of replanting. Previously, this would have been native forest that was cleared for cattle. In contrast, we're gonna be dipping down into almost 100% intact native forest. So you can see what real health is supposed to look like.
Waikumoi is on the slopes of Haleakala at over 8,000 acres. It's the top of the watershed, or people might also call it the ahupua'a of the east side communities of Maui. And this area was chosen because of the rare plants and animals that call this place home. So all right here, where there's Amau, Laukahi, or I'onui, Ohelo, Pukiave, this is what all of that area with invasive pines should be looking like. So we have six of the extant honeycreepers that remain here on Maui. We have the EEV, which is really iconic with its long pinkish-orange bill. We have the Apapane, the Hawaiʻamakihi. And then our last three are really special because they're endemic to Maui, only found here on the slopes of Haleakala. It's the kiwiku, the akohe-kohe, and the Maui aloahio. Where we are right now would have been considered Wawakua, a place that people like me, Maka'ainana, wouldn't be able to access. So a place where kahuna would come to gather la'olapa'o medicines. You really only come up here if you have business up here. So these birds, this is one of their last puʻuhonua, one of their last safe places that they can be. And I can't imagine what would happen if we weren't able to protect this place anymore. We're seeing less and less birds, we're hearing less and less birds, in particular the kiwiku and the akohe-kohe, two of our critically endangered honeycreepers that are only found on Maui, only found on the slopes of Haleakala. As climate change, as it warms through the seasons, the mosquitoes are able to climb higher and higher into these elevations, leaving very little habitat for our native birds to thrive.
There's an ivy in the tree over there.
Only when I moved here to Maui did I realize how important and how much the birds are ho'ailona, or signs to us, how they're indicators of the health of the forest. These birds have been here for generations before us. In the Kumulipo, in our cosmogony chant, they're in Va'ekolu in chapter 3, humans don't come until chapter 8. So they really were the ones that created these forests. They brought the seeds here, they pollinated, they made this livable so that all of these native plants could live in harmony, capture water for us. By using IIT, or the insect incompatibility technique, we can give our honey creepers a better chance at breeding, increasing their numbers every year. It's not going to be a quick fix, but I hope that my mo'opuna, my grandkids, are going to be able to walk into this forest and hear the dawn chorus of our honey creepers as they grow up too.
We're in the mosquito receiving facility, and these are mosquito cages. And this is a cage of mosquitoes. We are conducting a longevity assay, which means about 200 years ago, mosquitoes were introduced to Lahaina, and mosquitoes carry disease, specifically avian malaria and avian pox. Due to climate change, mosquitoes are able to move up higher and higher in elevation. And in the past few years, we've found mosquitoes in areas that never had mosquitoes before. And those are the areas, those upland forests are the areas where the birds live. Since that time, we've lost so many forest birds, and we can slow that loss by suppressing the mosquitoes. And that's what we're doing with this mosquito project. This is a mosquito longevity assay, so we're basically seeing how long they live. So I opened up a tube of mosquitoes after 24 hours, and then you aspirate the mosquitoes up, and then you do it again in another 24 hours, and again in another 24 hours until all the mosquitoes are gone. So basically we're just looking at the fitness of the mosquitoes. We are using male mosquitoes that do not feed on the birds or people. They are strictly nectar feeders. We're introducing them to the landscape to mate with the wild females, and then the wild females will lay sterile eggs. So all of this work is important because while there is a cultural aspect to it, it's important to preserve biodiversity. We're looking at extinction. We're watching it happen. And then these birds ecologically play a part in our forests. They were pollinators, and some of them spread seeds, some of them pollinate. I feel that I have to have a cause and work towards something, and it's important to me to do that and to try to save these birds across the whole Windward East Maui, where all of these honey creepers live. We're not only trying to save just two of the rarest, we're trying to save all of them.
The Maui Bird Conservation Center is one of two facilities that is ran by the San Diego Zoo Wildlife Alliance, located out here in Hawaii. So we are on the slopes of Haleakala. We're at about 3,700 feet. Our primary focus is to house critically endangered Hawaiian honey creepers to prevent them from going extinct in the wild. We're entering FBB2. So FBB2 is our primary breeding aviary building. In this building, we have 7 pairs of akikiki and 2 pairs of kiwiku. The akikiki first came into our care back in 2015. At that time, there were over 500 birds in the wild. Today, there's only about 5 birds left in the wild. We bring the birds into our care while the mosquitoes are being removed from the environment. And then once the mosquitoes are gone, we'll be releasing these birds back into the wild. Our day consists of coming in and checking all the birds, checking their health, kind of how they're interacting with their environment, providing fresh food and water on a daily basis. So all of our buildings are wrapped in mosquito screens, so all the birds that we care for are susceptible to the avian malaria and avian pox. So it's really important that we keep the mosquitoes out of the building. So a big part of our time is building maintenance. We try to have a kind of a neutral interaction with the bird. So we do spend very little time in the aviary interacting with the bird. It's more important that we're creating an environment that kind of matches the ecology in the wild. And so we have lots of native plants in the aviaries. We have everything kind of set up to limit how we interact with the birds. These kiwiku that we have, they are endemic to Maui. We brought them into our care back just in January of this year. So it's a big effort to save the kiwiku while the mosquitoes are being removed from the wild.
I first started working in conservation in 2012 as a AmeriCorps intern. And during that time, I was in the forest working with Maui's most critically endangered bird species. I was assessing their populations, getting an understanding of, you know, how many there were still remaining. Since 2012, so much has changed. We've gotten the technology, we've gotten the funding, we've gotten really the passion and drive to do something about that number one threat.
My hopes for the program is that it will continue and mosquito suppression will happen. And it'll happen quickly. And I hope in the future, my son and his children will be able to go into the forest and hear the birds.
So one day, if we do our job properly, the mosquitoes will be eliminated from the landscape and we can release the birds back into the wild and close the facility down. Yeah, we like to joke that if we do our jobs right, we'll lose our job.
It is incredible to go from, you know, the early days in which we weren't sure we could do anything about it, to now having a really critical tool to address their biggest threat. And mosquito control is really one of the best options we have for protecting our native species.